Before I start, I want to give all honors and glories and praises to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Waha, Wakach Kodash, Yahweh, which is the one true name of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shai, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, but his one true name is Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the elders and the apostles of Great Millstone who rule well and teach well, because those are the men who I've learned this truth from through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai. Peace, blessings, and salutations to the hopeful elect. Shalom to you, sincere brothers scattered abroad, pushing forth this word in truth and sincerity. I am the brother Mashiach, Irazakah, from the servants of Yahweh Wah Yahweh Shai Camp, Las Vegas, Nevada branch. And pretty much, this lesson is going to be titled as, Was Apostle Paul a Gentile or an Israelite? Was Apostle Paul a Gentile or an Israelite? And the reason why I'm titling this lesson as this is because I'm going to show you a video. We were at camp this past Saturday, and there was an individual that believed that Apostle Paul was a natural Gentile. He was a heathen, and he was not a natural Gentile. He was not a heathen. He was an Israelite. And we're going to prove that in this lesson. And then we're going to go into the scripture that a lot of people are stumbling over. They read that Acts 22 and they get a stumbling block there. They're not realizing that when Apostle Paul told that captain of the centurion that he was a Roman, he was saying he was a Roman citizen. He was not meaning he was an actual Roman. So you got a lot of fused individuals out there. So this is just edification purposes. And let's get to the video real quick.
Empire, the Medo-Persian Empire, the Greek Empire, Roman Empire, that's all Southern Kingdom. The Northern Kingdom, they went to a land. Yeah, they went to a land where no man dwelt. When you go into Second Edras, the 13th chapter. So when you go into the New Testament and it talks about the Jews first, that's talking about the Southern Kingdom.
No.
And when you go into the Gentiles,
that's because Paul wrote Romans.
Yeah, Paul wrote the Romans to the former Israelites.
But though he's a Gentile. He's when they call.
No, he's an Israelite.
See, so, you know, right there is where he went off at. So, the problem is a lot of people believe that Apostle Paul was a Gentile just because they read Acts 22:26-27. But they fail to realize that when Apostle Paul spoke onto that centurion, that chief captain, he was telling him that he was a Roman citizen. He wasn't telling him that he was a natural Gentile. He was telling him that he was a Roman citizen. We're going to prove that in these two little precepts, and then we're going to go into Google, and we're going to validate that he was a Roman citizen. He was not saying he was a heathen. He was an Israelite of the flesh. All right, and we can prove that easily when you go into Romans 11:1, but this is for edification purposes. You got people, they'll read that Acts 22:26-27. And they'll read these two precepts here Apostle Paul said that he was a Roman, but he was saying he was a Roman citizen. So let's read it. It says, when the centurion heard that, he went and told the chief captain, saying, take heed what thou doest, for this is a Roman. Right? Verse 27, then the chief captain came and said unto him, unto Paul, right? Tell me, art thou a Roman? He said, yeah. Paul said he was a Roman, but he was telling him that he was a Roman citizen. He wasn't saying he was a natural Roman, a natural heathen. All right, because we know that the Romans, those were Edomites, right? So we know that when Apostle Paul was saying to a Roman, he was telling him that he was a Roman because he was an Israelite that lived in the city of Rome. He was a Roman citizen. And we can prove that. Let's prove that. Now, anybody can look this up. This is Google. Anybody can look this up. It says it right here. It says, was Paul actually a Roman citizen? You see that? It says, one of the key pieces of historical background that would shed light on the understanding of Paul is the understanding of his citizenship. See, he was a citizen. He was an Israelite of the flesh, but he was a Roman citizen, just like how we are today. We're not called Israelites in this place called America, right? We're called what? American citizens, but we are Israelites. We're Israelites of the flesh, but what? We're called American citizens. So it's the same thing as in the time of Rome with Apostle Paul, right? It says, although not mentioned within his letters, Luke reports in the book of Acts that Paul, Apostle Paul, was a Roman citizen. See, in addition to being a Hellenistic Jew born in Tarsus. So there you go. You had Israelites. This is why, again, we keep telling you guys out there, you know, you wacky tacky Christian people, you other people out there. When it says to the Jew first and also to the Greek, that's talking about, the Greek there is talking about Israelite foreigners, all right? That Jew first, that's talking about Israelites. It's talking about the Southern Kingdom, because when you go into the secular history and you look at the Babylonian Empire, the Medo-Persian Empire, you had the Medes that came, and then you had the Persians that came. Then you had the Greeks, and then you had the Romans. That was all Southern Kingdom that went through that. The Northern Kingdom went to a land they already left. They went to a land where no man dwelt, which that's mentioned in 2 Edras, the 13th chapter. And the Northern Kingdom fell first. They went into captivity to the Assyrians, but after through time, they revolted against the Assyrian Empire, and they dwelt into a land where no man dwelt, which is that place called, what they call Azeroth, which is America. All right? The Northern Kingdom was already gone. Now, you still had, you know, little bits of the Northern Kingdom with Judah, right? Or with the Southern Kingdom in the time of the Roman Empire. There's a few little bit of Northern Kingdom there, but the majority of the Northern Kingdom was already gone. So mainly the main ones that went through the Babylonian Empire, the Medo-Persian Empire, the Greek Empire, the Roman Empire, that's all Southern Kingdom. The southern kingdom was the one that went through all that. And they were Hellenized. So they were cast out as Greek. They were cast out as Gentiles because they were what? Hellenized. And it says right here, it says Acts that Paul was a Roman citizen in addition to being a Hellenistic Jew born in Tarsus. So there you go. He was an Israelite. Apostle Paul was an Israelite, man. Let's prove it, and then we're going to go back to that video. Romans 11 and 1. See? Romans 11 and 1. This is Apostle Paul speaking. I say then, have the Most High cast away his people? Because you got a lot of people that believe that Israelites don't exist no more, and that the Lord, he's not just dealing with just Israel only anymore. He's dealing with all people. That's not in the Bible, though. That's not in the scriptures. So when you read this, you got to understand what is being said. Romans 11 and 1. I say then, have the Most High cast away his people? Have the Lord cast away the Israelites? And said that he's dealing with everybody. He's not dealing with just Israel no more. He's dealing with everybody. Is that what this scripture is saying? It says, God forbid. It means no. The Lord has not cast away his people. The Lord has not gotten rid of Israel. The Lord is dealing with Israel. The Lord always dealt with Israel. We're just in a particular lower state of a temporal punishment due to being rebellious and disobedient to the Lord. So the Lord put you 17 heathen nations above us in this present time now, because we're suffering due to being disobedient. So you 17 heathen nations are ruling over us today. You 17 heathen nations are above us, right? The scriptures even say in Deuteronomy 28 that we shall become the tail, right? And the heathen shall become the head. But the Lord is getting ready to flip it over where we're going to be the head and you guys are going to be the tail. And that's the time that we are getting ready to come into. The Lord is about to put everything back into its original state. But right now, the Israelites, the so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native American Indians have been put to a lower state. And we're under the curses right now. It says, for I also am an Israelite. See, Apostle Paul was an Israelite. He was not a natural heathen. Of the seed of Abraham, of the tribe of Benjamin. And a tribe of Benjamin, who is the tribe of Benjamin today? The so-called Jamaicans are the tribe of Benjamin. So if Apostle Paul was dwelling on the earth today, he would be titled as a so-called Jamaican if he was dwelling on the earth today. The Jamaicans are the tribe of Benjamin, which is of the southern kingdom. So when Apostle Paul wrote those epistles, when you look into, let me just edify you, when you look into Romans, when you go into 1 Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, right? Colossians, 1 Thessalonians, 2 Thessalonians, right? You're going into that Timothy, that Titus, mainly reading from Acts, I'll say, Romans, all the way down to 1st, 2nd Thessalonians. That's all Apostle Paul writing those epistles. Even when you go into Titus, he written those epistles. Those are to the former Israelites. When you go into Titus, the first chapter, you had the Israelites that were living in the city of Crete, which is Greece, and they were called what? Cretans. But they were Israelites, but they lived in the city of Crete, which was in Greece, and they were called what? Cretans. So you had Apostle Paul, and we can prove that. Let's look at it. Every time you read it, it always mentioned the letters of Apostle Paul, right? It says, Paul, a servant of Yahushua Mashiach, called to be an apostle, separated unto the Most High, the gospel, verse 2, which he had promised afar by his prophet in the Holy Scriptures. You see that? Let's look at another one. You see that? And it always talks about it. Paul, called to be an apostle of Yahushua Mashiach through the will of the Most High, and associates our brother. You see that? And it goes into the city of Corinth. It goes into the Corinthians, right? Which you had Israelites in the city of Corinth. And he's written these epistles, right? Just look at Galatia. You see that? Paul, an apostle, not of men by nearby man, but by Yahushua Mashiach and our power, the Father who raised him up from the dead. You see that? And all the brethren which are with me unto the churches of Galatia. You had Israelites in the city of Galatia, which is called Galatians. You had Israelites that were in that region. And Apostle Paul written those epistles to those regions, right? Let's look at Ephesians. It's the same thing. Paul, an apostle of Yahushua Mashiach, by the will of the Most High, to the saints, which the saints are the Israelites, Psalms 148 and verse 14, which are at Ephesus, which is an ancient city, right? And the faithful in Yahawashi HaMashiach. You see that? And it keeps doing the same thing. Philippians. Paul and Titus, right? Paul and Timotheus, right? Salakia, the servant of Yahawashi to all the saints who are the Israelites, Psalms 148, verse 14, in Yahawashi HaMashiach, which are at Philippi. You see that? With the bishops and deacons, Israelites. When each epistle he wrote was for the Israelites. There's nothing changing there. Right? Let's read this. Colossians. Paul, an apostle of Yahawashi Mashiach by the will of the Most High, and Timotheus, our brother, to the saints who are the Israelites, Psalms 148:14, and faithful brethren in Yahawashi, right, which are at Colossae, Salakia, grace be unto you, and peace from the Most High, our Father, and our Lord HaMashiach. You see that? So when you read, it's the same thing. 1 Thessalonians, Paul and Silvanus and Timotheus, right, onto the church of Thessalonians, which were Israelites, right? It says, which is in the Most High, the Father, and in Yahawashi, our Lord, HaMashiach Yahawashi, grace be unto you in peace from our power, the Father, and the Lord, HaMashiach Yahawashi. See? So all these epistles, Titus 2, right? Paul, a servant of the Most High, an epistle of Yahawashi Mashiach, according to the faith of Yahweh's elect, and the acknowledging of the truth which is after godliness. This is all written to the Israelites. This is all written to the Israelites. When Apostle Paul written those epistles, they were to the foreigner Israelites, right? So we proved it. We proved it. Apostle Paul was an Israelite, and when he written those epistles, he written them to the foreigner Israelites. When he written those epistles, he written them to the foreigner Israelites, right? Let's get that. You see that? It says, this is for edification purposes. Paul's epistles. What are the 12 epistles of Paul? You see that? It says Galatians, Romans, 1 Corinthians, right? Philemon, Philippians, Thessalonians, right? You also had Colossians, right? These were epistles. These were the letters that was written to the foreigner Israelites because they were Hellenized. They were Hellenized, man. They were Hellenized. So this was written, you know, I'm not going to go back, but again, those epistles was written to the foreigner Israelites. Acts 6 and 1. Let's get that. Acts 6 and 1. Right? Acts 6 and 1. It goes into that word Grecian, which that word Grecian goes into G1675 with
Strong's G, 1675, Hellenistes.
Right. So the Greek word for Hellenist or Grecian, the Greek word for Grecian is Hellenistes. That's the Greek word for Grecian, which goes into the English translation as Hellenist. And when you look at Hellenist, a Hellenist, one who imitates the manner and customs or the worship of the Greeks and use the Greek tongue. So when you look at the scriptures, it says to the Jew first and also to the Greek. That Greek there is talking about Israelite foreigners. It says used in the New Testament of Jews. That's talking about the southern kingdom, Jews. The southern kingdom, because the word Jew is short for Judah. All right. So you have the southern kingdom, which consists of Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. But those Jews were talking about the southern kingdom. It says used in the New Testament of Jews born in foreign lands and speaking Greek. They were cast out as Greek because they started following the way of the Greeks. They were speaking Greek, dressing Greek. They were in the ways of the Greeks. They were Hellenized. And as you looked, when I looked up about Apostle Paul being a Roman citizen, it said that he was even in a Hellenistic Jew. So you had Israelites Again, when you look up that word Greek there, to the Jew first, to the Greek, that Greek is talking about Israelite foreigners. Israelites of the flesh that had a Gentile state of mind. They were Hellenized. They had a Hellenistic mindset. They were in a Gentile state of mind. They were cast out as Gentiles. So to the Jew first and also the Greek, that's talking about Israelites and Israelite foreigners. That's what that's talking about. It's simple. So that individual there, you know, I would go back to the video, but I don't feel like going all the way back. But hey, this is just a quick hit, edification. Lord willing, this lesson was edifying. So when you read the scriptures there, and Apostle Paul said he was a Roman, he was saying he was a Roman citizen. He was not an actual heathen. He wasn't a he wasn't a natural Gentile. He was of Israelite descent. He was an Israelite. He was of the tribe of Benjamin. And when he written those epistles, those were to the foreigner Israelites who were dressing Greek, speaking Greek. They were in the days of the Greeks. They were Israelites that were in the Greek time of Greek, in the time of Rome, in the time of the Grecians. Those were Israelites that were Hellenized, man. And I got a precept too for that. Let me get it. Here's a precept for it. This is to prove that those Gentiles that you read that's talking about Gentiles or Greek to the Jew first, also the Greek, that's talking about Israelite foreigners. 1 Corinthians 12:2, it says, ye know that ye were Gentiles. See, this is Israelites, right? Ye know that ye were Gentiles carried away into these dumb idols, even as ye were led. You see that? So we were Israelites. We were Israelites of the flesh, but at that time, we were in a Gentile state of mind. It says, ye know that ye were Gentiles carried away unto the dumb idols, even as ye were led. So there you go. It's telling you, we're Israelites, but we were in the ways of the heathen. So we were cast out as Gentiles. You see that? So we were cast out as Gentiles, man. All right? We were cast out as Gentiles. This is why it's good for you to understand the scriptures. Because otherwise than that, you're going to be misconstrued with the scriptures. And then I'm going to end it with this right here. So like it. But I want to get this out again, though. See that? It says, but some dispute he is a Roman citizenship. None of the Paul's letters mention that Paul is a Roman citizen. But he is a Roman citizen. Because when you look right here, it's telling you the truth. Luke reports in the book of Acts that Paul was a Roman citizen. He was a Roman citizen. He said he was a Roman because he was telling the Roman that he was a Roman citizen. You had Israelites that lived in the city of Rome, and you had Israelites that were under the jurisdiction of the Roman Empire, right? You had the Israelites, they were oppressed during the captivity of the Romans, right? You had the Romans that were oppressing the Israelites, just as the Babylonians, just as the Medes and the Persians, right? The Medo-Persian Empire, the Greek Empire, and the Roman Empire, they were all Hellenized. It says, Luke reports in the book of Acts that Paul was a Roman citizen in addition to being a Hellenistic Jew born in Tarsus. So there you go. Israelites, those Greeks that you read about, to the Jew first, also the Greek, that's talking about Israelite foreigners. We proved it in Acts 6:1. So, hey, Lord willing, this was edifying. Till next time, I say shalom.